Do you mind going, guys? Do you mind going over to Menage over here? Yeah, yeah, because then we kind of then we know the Tremolo group is together. If you don't mind, we're trying to get the groups together, and if you can get your group together, it's great.
Just one more half a
second. The first band has to start in half an hour. We were four musicians releasing our own record, and I guess the whole philosophy of the label kind of sprung from that fact that we were doing it ourselves. I was so struck, I could not sleep for nights, and the daytime was a wonderful dream. And then when we started releasing other bands, we did 50-50 deals because we just basically thought that's a fair deal. And we kept on doing that because it felt good, basically. I mean, there's a high level of loyalty between the band and the label. And nobody feels that they're working for each other, that we're working together.
I think because the way the label started out, I mean, with Jebo and just being bands themselves, I think they really understand how to let the musicians do their thing.
Most of them are musicians. They know what music is, how to play it. What is a band? What is a touring band? What is a playing band? A recording band? All that. They all know what it's like from the inside out.
We started out as a noise rock label, doing exclusively kind of lo-fi, very noisy, avant-garde rock music. They were using wristbands. At a point, after like 6-7 years, we signed a pop band, an indie pop band called Superheroes. Pretty much at the same time, we recorded the first record with the Tremolo Biergut, which is a retro band. And we kind of started two other directions for the label. And I think these three directions have been, you know, going along the way. And I think there was a turning point for us. We still have these kind of experimental, noisy bands, and you know, like Shiny Darkly, and you know, Beta Satan played tonight. Then the retro stuff like Power Solo, Heavy Trash, Tremolo Biergut, The Attacks. And then the pop sides, which would be, you know, Superheroes and Junior Senior, Lies in the Hands of Light. I want you to open your eyes up. And then bands like Ravenettes, who kind of cross over between the noise rock and the retro. Lipstick on my face.
Working with Sune from the Ravenettes back when he was writing the material for the band, and that's when they signed with Crunchy Frog, and I got in there, got to sort of be part of the family, and slowly I started to photograph other bands as well. It goes something like this.
Through and looked at the roster, the bands that were on the label, once I became more familiar with it. And I saw bands that I knew, like the Ravenettes and 18th Die, Junior Senior, bands like that, and couldn't believe that they were all on one label. That has to stay
unsigned.
seems like there are a lot of bands on the label that are kind of related but disparate. But when you draw a line between them all to the label, there is sense there. So there's like psychobilly, there is like really sort of trashy sounding rock and roll. There is psychedelic guitar music. There is things with a surf atmosphere. And taken individually, they're like a little island of artists. But when you draw a line to Crunchy Frog, it always makes a lot of sense that they're on that label.
Started doing a lot of photos with Thomas Troelsen and Superheroes, and then I did a lot with Junior Senior as well, and then suddenly it all went crazy.
In 2002 and 3, when we released Junior Senior and the Ravenettes, actually in the course of 3 months in the beginning of 2002. And both bands really kind of hit, maybe not the mainstream, but they kind of, you know, they hit some kind of wave or something, and they became pretty popular.
A dynamic Danish duo dancing up the charts, and beware, it's highly infectious. This is Junior Senior.
Exploded kind of the brand of Crunchy Frog all of a sudden. We were a well-known label internationally.
Our next guests are a wonderful rock and roll band from Denmark, and this is the new CD. It's entitled Chain Gang of Love. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Ravenettes.
Incredible time to be part of it too, also on a personal level. I mean, it was basically all my contacts in the UK and the States came through Crunchy Frog.
I don't think a lot of stuff has changed in a way. Being a good record label is, you know, finding great bands, making great records, you know, trying to promote them any way you can. I mean, what has changed is the way that you can, you know, promote it, how you can market it and sell it, you know, how you can record it, all those things. But the core business is actually the music, you know. The music and the artists, and I think that's the same. Came with the wind and danced through the dust. Strike me once more, he beat me to a bust.
I would say it's very similar to how the indie labels in the United States work. I think, you know, it's the can-do spirit, you know, the whole DIY thing. It's something I was very, very familiar with and part of in the 90s in the United States, where Merge Records is and Touch and Go and Matador and labels like that. And to me, Crunchy Frog is very much in the same spirit as that. We played in a band. We were cool, all right. So we thought we should go ahead and make a try. Got a quarter inch eight track and borrowed okay mics. Oh,
I guess we learned a lot of lessons the hard way. We did a lot of mistakes. We still make mistakes. along the way, I think we just find the right, the partners in different countries, you know, people we want to work with that actually delivered on promises made and stuff like that. And we keep working with those people, and there's other people that kind of fucks you over, and you don't continue that collaboration.
An independent mentality, independent mindset, and the people are optimistic and good to work with, and realistic, and just a pleasure really. So I think that the spirit of the label kind of bleeds out into the audience, and I think the bands feel it too. So there's like a really positive spirit at the center of it that touches on everything that Crunchy Frog does and gives the atmosphere a really positive spin.
All these blind alleys you go down, I mean, that's, I guess it's learning it the hard way, but I don't think there's any other way to really do it, unless you're on a major label where there's a structure and a system. It's DIY, you know?
Crunchy is a label basically of kids, where you get the feeling that it's fun for everybody involved, and that makes it fun to be on the label.
I know these guys for more than 10 years, and I know that they are the label, and they're dedicated 24/7, 9/11, 7/11, whatever.
It's like one big family, and if you work hard, you live. If you don't, you'll wake up with a horse in your bed, at least the head. That's pretty much.
That's the Crunchy family.
And I'll sleep under the tide of dreams. I'll dream under the wings of time.
I think it's the label that I've worked with where the artists have the most freedom, I think, artistically. I mean, there's always been the music that's been in focus, and more so than making a hit, and even then some of them have made some hits.
They still have integrity for all the bands that are kind of low end in the income. They still work a lot on that, and I think a lot of labels kind of just don't do that.
Today, and you know, and being with all the bands and all our friends and the people traveled from America and London and Germany and Iceland, and people came from all over to be here today. It felt really good.
Strange that now it's 20 years already, but there's a lot of tradition, and I think there's a long line of good bands now, so a lot of bands want to sort of be part of that.
I mean, the way we started out feels very distant, and it seems that I've been doing this for 20 years. And I'm 43, so it's half my lifetime. So, I mean, it's basically been my life. So it means a lot. I can't really say that I'm doing much outside of Crunchy Frog. So it's meant everything to me. After all your songs.